Dear students, welcome once again to VTU Ishikshana Program 6. In today's class, let us find the orthogonal trajectories of the curves given in polar form. The working procedure is very similar to finding orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves in Cartesian form. Suppose the given family of curves given in polar form is f of r comma theta c equal to 0, where c is the parameter. The working procedure, as a first step, we try to eliminate the parameter c from this relation and find or obtain the differential equations in the form f of r comma theta comma dr by d theta equal to 0. So in this differential equation, we replace dr by d theta by minus r square into d theta by dr. Then the obtained differential equation, which is f of r comma theta comma minus r square d theta by dr equal to 0, nothing but the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories. We solve this differential equation and obtain the family of curves, which are nothing but the orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves. So let me consider a problem. So let us consider problem number 1. Find the orthogonal trajectories of the family of curves. The family of curves R over N is equal to A into sine N theta. A is constant. So by default, A is the parameter here, and we have to form as a first step the differential equation of this family of curves by eliminating A. That means differentiating once. Solutions. So given family of curves is R power N into A sine N theta. Call this as equation 1. Differentiate this with respect to theta. Differentiate with respect to theta. So or you can take log and then differentiate. So let us first take log on both the sides and then simplify and then differentiate with respect to theta. So log r power n is equal to log a into sine n theta. But let us simplify this and then differentiate with respect to theta. So by if identities of logarithm, this can be written as n into log r is equal to log a into b is log a plus log b, that is log sine n theta. Now differentiate with respect to theta. Let us differentiate with respect to theta now. N divided by r into dr by d theta is equal to a log a is constant because a is constant, so 0 plus 1 divided by differentiation of log sine n theta, 1 divided by sine n theta into cos n theta, that is differentiation of sin n theta, is n into cos n theta. So therefore, n divided by r into dr by d theta is equal to n into cos n theta by sin n theta is cot n theta. Cot n theta. Okay. Now I can cancel this n. So I get 1 by r dr by d theta is equal to cot n theta. So this is the differential equation of 1, which is the differential equation of 1. So I have eliminated the constant. In the process of differentiation, the constants got eliminated by itself. So this is free from A, and this is the first order ordinary differential equation of the given family of curves, which is the differential equation of one. So now, here the first step. Second step, we replace in this differential equation dr by d theta by minus r square into d theta by dr. So let us do that. Replace dr by d theta by minus r square d theta by dr into, replace dr by d theta by minus r square d theta by dr in this equation, then 1 divided by r into minus r square d theta by dr is equal to cot n theta. Cot n theta. Replace dr by d theta by minus r square d theta by dr. So 1 r you can cancel. So this is minus r d theta by dr is equal to cot n theta. Cot n theta. So this is the differential equation of the orthogonal triangles. So we call this as equation 3, which is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories, orthogonal trajectories. Now, so let us solve the differential equation 3. So this is a first order differential equation which can be solved very easily by the method of separation of variables. So separating the variables, dr by r, d theta by cot n theta is equal to minus dr by r. The variables are separated. D theta by cot n theta is equal to minus dr by r. Okay, so 1 by cot n theta is tan n theta, so therefore tan n theta d theta is equal to minus dr by r. Therefore, its solution is integral of each side. So, integral tan n theta d theta is equal to minus integral dr by r plus some arbitrary constant. So, let me take it as log c. So, integration of tan n theta is 1 by n with negative sign minus 1 by n log cos n theta or plus 1 by n log secant n theta. This is equal to integration of dr by r is minus log r plus log c. Okay. Now multiply throughout by n. Multiply by n throughout. Then this is minus log cos n theta is equal to minus n into log r plus n into log c. R, this can be known as minus log cos n theta is equal to minus log r power n plus log c power n. So further, you take it to the other side, left hand side, then this is plus log r power n minus log cos n theta is equal to log c power n. So log a minus log b can be written as log r power n divided by cos n theta is equal to log c power n. So comparing both sides, so therefore r power n divided by cos n theta is equal to c power n. Therefore, r power n is equal to b into cos n theta, where b is c power n. So this is the solution of the orthogonal differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories, and it is the orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves. So which is the orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves. Of given family of curves. So let me consider another problem. Let me consider another problem. Problem 2. Find the orthogonal trajectories of the family of of curves, family of curves, r power n into cos n theta is equal to a power. So given equation, a given family of curves is in polar form, that is r power n into cos n theta is equal to a power. Now let me simplify this before I differentiate with respect to theta and eliminate this arbitrary constant a from the equation in order to obtain the required first order ordinary differential equation. So take log on both sides to the base e r for n is into cos n theta is equal to log a power n. A is constant. Now log a into b, so this can be written as log r power n plus log cos n theta is equal to n into log a. Log a is constant, n into log a is also constant. So further, this can be written as n into log r into log r. Plus log cos n theta is equal to n into log a. Now let me differentiate this with respect to theta. Differentiate with respect to theta. So this is n by r, differentiation of log r, 1 by r into dr by d theta. So n by r into dr by d theta plus log cos n theta is 1 divided by cos n theta into minus n into sin n theta. Sin n theta is equal to n into log a is constant, therefore its differentiation is 0. Okay. And further, okay. So now I can cancel this n throughout. So I get 1 by r dr by d theta minus sin n theta by cos n theta is tan n theta is equal to 0. Call this as equation number 1 and here 2. So 2 is the differential equation of the given family of curves 1. So which is the differential equation, differential equation of the given family of curves 1. Okay. Now in this differential equation, let me replace dr by d theta by minus r square into d theta by dr. So replace dr by d theta by minus r square d theta by dr in the differential equation 2, then we obtain 1 by r into minus r square d theta by dr minus tan n theta is equal to 0. So I can cancel 1 r. So I get minus r d theta by dr is equal to tan n theta. Tan n theta. Call this as equation 3. Okay, so this is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectory. Solving this equation, you obtain the family of curves, which are nothing but the orthogonal trajectory of the given family of curves. So which is the differential equation of the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories. Solve the equation, differential equation 3. Okay. Now, this is the first order differential equation which can be solved easily using separation of variables. So separating the variables we have. Separating the variables we have. d theta divided by tan n theta is equal to minus dr by r. So 1 by tan n theta is cot n theta. So therefore, cot n theta d theta is equal to minus dr by r. Now the variables are separated, therefore its solution is integration of each side. Cot n theta d theta is equal to integral minus integral dr by r. So let me write the constant of integration as log c only for some convenience. So integration of cot theta is log sine theta. So cot n theta is 1 by n log sine n theta. N theta is equal to minus integral of dr by r is log r plus log c. Now let me multiply throughout by n. Multiply by n throughout. Then log sine n theta is equal to minus n into log r plus n into log c. Okay. Then further I can write this as log sine n theta is equal to minus log r power n plus log c power n. Okay. Further, take this to the left hand side. So log sine n theta plus log r power n is equal to log c power n. Okay. Now this can be written as log r power n into sine n theta is equal to log c power n. Okay. So therefore, r power n into sine n theta is equal to c power n. So this is the solution of the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories, and hence orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves. Which is the orthogonal trajectory? Which is the required orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves So lastly, let me consider another problem. R is equal to 2a into cos theta plus sin theta. Curves R is equal to 2a into cos theta plus sin theta. Okay. So given family of curves is in polar form. So let me consider the given family of curves, the solution for the given family of curves. R is equal to 2a cos theta plus sin theta. So this is the given family of curves in polar form. Call this by equation number 1. Okay, so let me simplify first. Take log on both sides. Log r is equal to, if you take log on both sides, log 2a plus log cos theta plus sin theta. So this is log 2a plus log cos theta plus sin theta. Plus sine theta. Now differentiate with respect to theta. Differentiate with respect to theta. So differentiation of log r 1 by r into dr by d theta. 2a is constant, so log 2a is constant, plus 1 over cos theta plus sin theta into differentiation of cos theta plus sin theta, that is minus sin theta plus cos theta. Okay. Now further, you can rewrite this as, now our A is eliminated and we have obtained a first order differential equation. But rearranging, this can be written as 1 by r, simplifying dr by d theta is equal to cos theta minus sin theta divided by cos theta plus sin theta. Call this as equation. So this is the differential equation of the given family of curves. So which is the which is the differential equation of one given family of curves one. So in this differential equation, let us substitute dr by d theta by minus r square d theta by dr. So you get 1 by r into minus r square d theta by dr. And further I can simplify. I can take cos theta outside here. It will become cos theta into 1 minus tan theta. The denominator also, if I take cos theta outside, I am dividing numerator and denominator by cos theta. I get 1 minus tan theta divided by 1 plus tan theta, dividing numerator and denominator by cos theta. Dividing numerator and denominator by cos theta. Numerator and denominator by cos theta. Okay. Now further, I can cancel one r. This is minus r d theta by dr. So this can be written as tan pi by 4 is 1. Tan pi by 4 minus tan theta divided by 1 plus tan pi by 4 into tan theta. So this will be of the form tan of a minus b. So this can be written as tan pi by 4 minus theta, because tan pi by 4 is 1. Tan pi by 4 is 1. Tan pi by 4 is 1. So this is nothing but the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories. So which is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories. Which is the differential equation of the orthogonal trajectories. Now solve 3. Solve the differential equation 3. Now this is again first order ordering differential equation, which can be solved easily by separating the variables. So separating the variables we have d theta divided by tan pi by 4 minus theta is equal to minus dr by r. Further, 1 by tan pi by 4 minus theta is cot pi by 4 minus theta d theta is equal to minus dr by r. The variables are separated variables are separated, and hence its solution is integration of each cell. Okay. So therefore, integral cot pi by 4 minus theta d theta is minus integral dr by r plus some integral constant. I will take that as c, log c. Integration of cot theta, cot x is log sin x, and here cot of pi by 4 minus theta, so coefficient of theta is minus 1, so this is minus 1 by 1, or simply minus log sin pi by 4 minus theta is equal to minus log r plus log c. So what if I write minus sine? So this is log sine pi by 4 minus theta is equal to log r minus log c. Now further, you can write this as log sine pi by 4 minus theta log a minus log b. So this can be written as log r by c. So therefore, sine pi by 4 minus theta is r divided by c. So r is equal to, so therefore r is equal to c times sine pi by 4 minus theta. Now let me expand this, like sine of a minus b formula, sine of a minus b. So r is equal to c into sine pi by 4 is 1 by root 2 into cos theta minus cos pi by 4 is also 1 by root 2 into sine theta. So therefore, r is equal to c divided by root 2 into cos theta minus sine theta. So let me write c by root 2 as b into cos theta minus sine theta, where b is c divided by root 2. So which is the orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves? Which is the orthogonal trajectories of the given family of curves? Given family of curves. Given family of curves. Okay, this completes the topic on finding orthogonal trajectories of a given family of curves, both in Cartesian and polar form. The next application of ordinary differential, first order ordinary differential equation prescribed in your syllabus is Newton's law of cooling. So let me consider the next application of ODE of first order to Newton's law of cooling. Newton's law of cooling. So let me write the statement of the Newton's law of cooling. The next application is Newton's law of cooling. Newton's law of cooling. Newton's law of cooling. Newton's law of cooling. So according to Newton's law of cooling, according to Newton's law of cooling, the temperature, according to Newton's law of cooling, the temperature of a body changes at a rate which is proportional, to the difference in temperature, proportional to the difference, in temperature between temperature between that of the surrounding, that of the surrounding medium, and that of the body itself, Okay. The law says rate of change of temperature. That is, the temperature of a body changes at a rate which is proportional to the difference in temperature between the body and that of the surrounding. That is, maybe a medium, surrounding medium or atmosphere. So now, if theta, so mathematically how do we write this, converting this statement into mathematical equation? If theta naught is the temperature of the surrounding, temperature of the surrounding, of the surrounding temperature of the surrounding and theta is the temperature of the body, the temperature of the body at any time t, temperature of the body at any time t, then rate of change of temperature, changes at a rate, temperature of a body changes at a rate that is given by d theta by dt, which is proportional to the difference in temperature between the surroundings and the body itself, that is equal to theta minus theta naught. This is the mathematical equation. Therefore, d theta by dt is equal to k, if k is the constant of proportionality, into theta minus theta naught, where k a positive quantity, k greater than 0 is the constant of proportionality, is the constant of proportionality at the negative side indicate the cooling of the body with the increase in time. Negative side indicates the cooling of the body, indicate the cooling of the body with increase in time, with the increase of time, with the increase of time, or with the increase in time. So this is the mathematical statement or modeling of this statement. So, try to remember this equation, d theta by dt is equal to minus k into theta minus theta. Now, let me consider a problem on this application. So, let me consider one example. A body originally at 80 degree centigrade cools down, to 60 degree centigrade in 20 minutes. The temperature of the air that is surrounding, the temperature of the air being 40 degree centigrade. What will be the temperature? The question is, what, when, will temperature of the body, what will be the temperature of the body after 40 minutes, after 40 minutes from the original, from the original, what will be the temperature of the body after 40 minutes from the original? This is the problem. Now let me write the mathematical statement of this Newton's law of cooling, the solution for solution. If theta is the temperature of the body, if theta be the temperature of the body, at any time t, then d theta by dt is equal to minus k into theta minus theta.
Okay.
So here theta naught is the temperature of the air is 40 degree centigrade. Now let me substitute in this differential equation. So therefore, d theta by dt is equal to minus k theta minus 40. Now this is a first order ordinary differential equation which can be solved easily by the separation of variables. Now separate the variables. Separating the variables. D theta divided by theta minus 40 is equal to minus kt. Now the variables are separated. The solution is integration of each side. So therefore, integral d theta divided by theta minus 40 is equal to minus k integral dt plus some constant c. Okay. Now, integration of 1 over ax plus b, 1 by a log ax plus b. So, quotient of theta is 1. So, this is integrating, you get log theta minus 40. Log theta minus 40 is equal to minus k t plus c. Or further, I can write this as log e power, that is log theta minus 40 is equal to log e power minus kt plus c. Therefore, theta minus 40 is equal to e power minus kt plus c. So further, we can write this as e power minus kt into e power c. So therefore, theta minus 40 is equal to capital A e power minus kt, where A is e power c arbitrary constant. Okay. Now call this as equation number 1, equation which is the solution of this differential equation. Now look at the problem. Originally at 80 degree centigrade temperature of the body, that means theta is 80 when T is equal to 0. So let us use this condition. Theta is 80 degree centigrade when at T is 0 initially, when T is equal to 0. Therefore, 80 minus 40 is equal to A into e power minus kt, 0, that is t is 0, A. Therefore, A is equal to 40. Therefore, A is equal to 40. Because t is 0, e power 0 is 1, so A is 40. Now, substitute in 1. Substitute in one. Then theta minus 40 is equal to 40 into e power minus kt. Now look at the problem once again. It cools down from 80 degree to 60 degree in 20 minutes. So when T is 20, theta is 60 degrees. So theta, temperature of the body, will cool down to 60 degree in 20 minutes. That is where T is 20 minutes. 20 minutes. Okay. Now substitute. So 60 minus 40 is equal to 40 e power minus 20k. E power minus 20k. Okay. Now 60 minus 40 is 20 is equal to 40 into e power minus 20k. Or e power minus 20k is equal to 40 divided by 20 divided by 40 is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. Now let me simplify. I will take log on both sides. Log e power minus 20k is equal to log of, this is equal to log 1 minus log 2. So this is 0 minus log 2. 0 minus log 2. So therefore, minus 20k log a power b, b log e, log e is 1. So therefore, minus 20k is equal to minus log 2, or k is equal to log 2 by 20, log 2 divided by 20. Now substitute this in this equation. You call this as equation number 2. Substitute into the value of k. So there substitute in the equation 2, then theta minus 40 is equal to 40 into e power minus log 2 by 20 times t log 2 divided by 20 t. Okay, so now since we have to find the temperature of the body when time is 40. So when t is equal to 40, when t is equal to 40 minutes from detonation to theta minus 40, or theta is equal to 40 plus 40 into e power minus, so power distance from 3, this equation. Substitute in 2, we get this equation. Call this as 3. When t is equal to 40 minutes, from this relation itself, 3, or when t is equal to 40 minutes, theta from 3, okay, from 3, theta is equal to 40 plus 40 times e power log 2 minus log 2 divided by 20 into t is 40. So if you simplify using calculator, you get 50. Otherwise also you can do it very easily. So this is 40 into 1 plus e power minus, so this is 2 e power minus 2 log 2 then further you can write this as theta is equal to 40 into 1 plus this can be written as 2 power minus 2, that is 1 by 4. So this is 40 into 1 plus 1 by 4. So theta is 40, 4 plus 1 to 5 by 4. So this is 10. So 10 into 5 is 50 degree centigrade. So after 40 minutes, the temperature of the body is 50 degree centigrade. Okay. Now let me consider second example. If the temperature of the air, is 30 degree centigrade and the substance cools from our body. Substance means body here, cools from 100 degree centigrade to 70 degree centigrade. Yeah. 15 minutes. In 15 minutes, five. When the temperature five, when the temperature will be 40 degrees. When be 40 degrees centigrade. So here we have to calculate the time here. Unlike in the previous problem, for a given time we determine the temperature of the body. So here, when the substance or a body achieves 40 degree centigrade, what will be the time required for it? That is the question here. Now, let me write down the mathematical statement of this solution. Newton's law of cooling. If theta is the temperature of the body, temperature of the body, then at any time the body, at any time t, then d theta by dt is equal to minus k into theta minus theta. So here theta naught is 30 degree centigrade. Here theta naught is 30 degree centigrade. So therefore d theta by dt is equal to minus k into theta minus 30. Theta minus 30. Okay. Theta minus 30. Okay. So this is a first order differential equation which can be solved easily by separating the variables. We have d theta divided by theta minus 30 is equal to minus k dt. The variables are separated now. So therefore, its solution is integration of each side d theta divided by theta minus 30 is equal to minus k into integral dt plus some constants. So log of theta minus 30 is the integration of this. So this is log of theta minus 30 is equal to minus k t plus c. So like in the previous problem, so this can be written as theta minus 30 is equal to a into e power minus kt. Using the explanation as given in the previous problem, we can directly also write like this. So where a is e power c. So now the substance, that is the body, cools from 100 degree centigrade to 70 degree centigrade. So initially the temperature of the body is 100 when t is 0. Theta is 100 when t is 0. So 100 minus 30 is equal to A. 20 is 0, E 4 0 is 1, A is 70. So therefore, A is equal to 70. Now substitute in this, we call this as equation 1. Substitute A 1. Then theta minus 30 is equal to 70 into e power minus k t. Okay, call this as equation number 2. Again, it cools down from 100 degree centigrade to 70 degree centigrade in 15 minutes. So body of the temperature is 70 when T is, time is 15 minutes. So theta is 70 degree centigrade when T is equal to 15 minutes. So let me substitute here. So 70 minus 30 is equal to 70 e power in 15 minutes, that is minus 15k. Okay. So 70 minus 30, that is 40, is equal to 70 e power minus 15k. So therefore, e power minus 15k is 40 divided by 70 is equal to 4/7. So take log on both sides. Log e power minus 15k is equal to log 4 divided by 7. So therefore, minus 15k is equal to log 4 divided by 7. So therefore, k is minus log 4 by 7 divided by 15. Now substitute this in this equation. Substitute in 2. Then theta minus 30 is equal to 70 into e power minus k. So this becomes plus log 4/7. Divided by 15 times t. We call this as equation 3. Now, here we have to calculate time t when the body has 40 degrees centigrade. So we have to calculate. We have to calculate time t when the body has, when the body has 40 degree centigrade. Body has 40 degrees centigrade. So therefore, 40 minus 30 is equal to 70 into e power log 4 divided by 7 divided by 15 into T, that is T. So this is 10 is equal to 10 is equal to 70 into e power log 4 by 7 log 4 divided by 7 divided by 15 times t. So therefore e power log 4 by 7 divided by 15 t is equal to 10 divided by 70 or 1 by 7. Now take log on both sides. Log e power log of 4 by 7 t divided by 15 is equal to log of 1 by 7, which is equal to a z log 1 minus log 7, log 1 minus log 7, or this is log 4 by 7 divided by 15 into t is equal to minus log 7, because log 1 is 0. Log 1 is 0. Okay, so therefore t, you want t, t is equal to minus 15 times log 7 divided by log 4 divided by 7. So t is minus 15 log 7 divided by log 4 by 7. So simplify you get t is equal to 52.15. T, the time when the body has the temperature, the temperature will be, time will be 52.15 minutes for the body to have temperature 40 degree centigrade. So this completes the application of ordinary differential equations, particularly for the two cases. One is orthogonal trajectory and another one is just now, which I am going to conclude, that is Newton's law of cooling. The another application of ordinary differential equation is for LR circuits that I will be considering in my next class. So I will conclude my session today. Thank you. I will continue my topics in my next class.